Hey, welcome back to the channel. For those of you who may be new here, thank you for checking us out. And for those who are active subscribers, I thank you very much. As many of you already know, DJI released their newest drone yesterday, the Mavic Air. The Mavic Air includes many new functions and features, some of which include a three-axis mechanical gimbal with dampeners for a more steady shot. It takes 4K video at 30 frames per second, recording in 100 megabits per second to capture everything in ultra high definition. It has 8 gigabits of internal storage. It has 12 megabit still shot, a foldable design, and several new quick shot features, including what's called Asteroid and Boomerang. In order to support these latest releases of the Mavic Air, DJI coordinated the release of its latest DJI Go 4 app, which is version 4.2.4, which just came out yesterday. So some of the items listed in this new software release are specific to this aircraft, the Mavic Air, and include the following. So it includes what they call APAS, which is Advanced Pilot Assistance System. So they added that. This allows the Mavic Air to bypass certain obstacles automatically during flight. Again, the Mavic Air has front, back, and rear sensors, unlike the Spark, which only has forward and bottom sensors. The active track can now identify multiple subjects, improving the visual identification stability and operation efficiencies. Added new Boomerang and Asteroid quick shots with, and this is important, a firmware version 01.00.0100. Again, that's firmware. Gesture mode has been upgraded to smart capture mode, which improves identification, stability, and control range. Again, this is with a firmware version 01.00.0100 firmware. Enhanced pano shooting with improved image stitching and effects with, again, the same firmware update. Photo and videos can be stored in the Mavic Air's internal storage. Again, in case you forget your SD card. And there were fixed bugs and features updates according to the software notes. So it does appear this software update also includes a firmware update as well. Up until this point, the firmware version for the DJI Spark was version 1.00.0900. That was released back in December 21st, 2017. If you purchased the newest DJI Mavic Air, this aircraft will be running firmware version 01.00.0100. So it's a newer firmware version from what I can tell and what's in the notes. I haven't received my Mavic Air yet, but looking at the DJI website, the Mavic Air will have intelligent batteries just like its predecessors. And when the firmware versions are out of sync, the DJI Go app will inform you of the inconsistencies. Okay. That's it for now. Again, I do thank everyone who's an active subscriber. I hope those of you who have not subscribed will think about subscribing and stay tuned for some Mavic Air videos. I'm hoping to have the newest DJI product in my hands early next week. And of course, I'll still be flying my Spark as well. Have a great evening. And I did include at the end some screenshots pre and post of the app and what it looks like after you do the updates. So hope you found this helpful. And good flying.